Dr. Thomas, Institute Director and Chairman, Chennai Fertility Center and Research Institute. We have a branch in Chennai, Pondicherry, and Tirupati, and Bangladesh also. So today I'm going to discuss about role of embryologist in IVF success. So many people think that, you know, IVF is only belongs to, you know, gynecologist or maybe the IVF clinician, but that is not true. IVF is like a, you know, 50-50. 50% plays a role by clinician, and then 50% the major role or important role is played by IVF scientist or embryologist. So you can ask me, who is exactly embryologist? The embryologist is actually who exactly handles the gametes from outside of the environment, that means in the laboratory environment. So he facilitate like an egg and sperm mix together and give a life to the embryo or the baby. So you should also know about the basic knowledge on, you know, like a gamete biology or maybe, you know, like a mammalian reproductive biology. So he has a wide knowledge should be there to make sure that, you know, the pregnancy will be adequately or maybe the success will be maintained properly. A good embryologist should have a gamete and their, you know, optimal requirement, the knowledge should be there. And the skill and the precision of handling of the gametes and micromanipulation technique and the other technique has to be there. And you should also well versed like all IVF technology, like IUI semen preparation technique, and you know, like IVF insemination technique, and then culturing of the embryo, and culturing of the embryo to go to the blastocyst, and selecting the viable embryo for the embryo transfer. So many people think that, you know, the IVF is only played by clinician, but as I already mentioned in the previous, but embryologist plays a crucial role to achieve a success rate. So how you will work in the laboratory? Especially embryologist will check the, you know, semen sample and decide for what type of treatment this couple can easily get. Say for example, you know, semen sample is very low. You should advise the doctor or you should advise the clinician saying that the count is very low or morphology is very low or the sperm quality is very poor, very bad. They have to go for, you know, like an ICSI treatment if the sample is very, very bad. ICSI treatment in the means, you know, if the semen sample is very weak, low sperm quality, low motility, low morphology, so they have to go for a special treatment called as an ICSI treatment. This is one step advanced than the IVF treatment. So you can ask me, what is an IVF treatment? IVF treatment is, you know, we can stimulate the woman from second day or third day from the menstrual cycle using the recombinant FSH injection and monitor them for the follicular study and see them if the follicles reaching more than 80 millimeter, we can trigger using the either GnRH analog or maybe you can trigger with the HCG. So whatever it may be, you can do that. So after triggering, we'll take them to the theater and then give a mild anesthesia, and then we collect the egg using the ultrasound guided, like a transvaginal ultrasound guided. We can collect all the eggs and then give it to the embryologist. Here, embryologist will screen the oocyte in the follicular fluid. He will identify the egg, and then these eggs will be even matured in the laboratory, and then decide for whether IVF or ICSI. The sperm count is very good, they can go for IVF. That means prepare the sperms and, you know, inseminate to the, you know, to the dish, you know, contain the egg with the culture media. So generally, if there is a you know, like a more than 5 to 10 eggs, we can keep in a two different dishes, like each egg in the 5 eggs, and then inseminate, you know, like a 10,000 to up to 1 lakh sperm can be inseminated into the per oocyte. Then we can keep this one for, you know, 16 to 18 hours and check for the fertilization. So here, egg and sperm is combined together in the petri dish. This job is done by embryologist. After 16 hours to 18 hours, the embryologist will come and check that the sperm and egg is, you know, like a fused together and become a pronuclear stage. And if it's fertilized, you will just collect those fertilized pronuclear embryo and then transfer it to the flesh medium, and then you wait for another 24 to 48 hours to become a, you know, like a 2 to 4 cell or 4 to 6 cell embryo. So these embryo, again every 48 hours, they have to change. Embryos will change to the culture media, and then you will culture. That's called as a sequential culture, or maybe like an extended culture. So once you culture, and during this period, maybe you can select the embryo on second day, like a 4 to 6 cell embryo, or third day, something like a 6 to 8 cell embryo, and then fifth day, it's like an early blastocyst or expanded blastocyst. These embryo can be selected and transferred to the human nucleus, depend upon the endometrium condition. So endometrium has to be good, there is no fluid, and the endometrial pattern should be good, blood flow should be good. Ideally, 9 to 12 millimeter, if the endometrium thickness is there, the implantation will be good. So as I mentioned that, if the sperm quality is very good, more than 10 million, 50% motility, good sample, or at least 5 million with 50% motility, good sample, we can go for a IVF treatment. But there are some patients, very less sperms will be there, like occasionally few sperms will be there, or he doesn't have a sperms, we have to take the sperm from the epididymis, or maybe from the testis, or maybe from the directly from the testicular tissue. So this type of semen sample, it's very difficult to do either IUI or IVF treatment. So this sample has to be done ICSI treatment only. So here also you need a good skilled embryologist to check into the microscope and see which is the good sperm and which is the, you know, viable sperm, which is the no vacuolated sperms. So embryologist can check in the microscope and select the viable best sperm, and then he can directly inject into the egg. That's called as an intracytoplasmic sperm injection. If his embryologist is very good, he can achieve a good fertilization rate around 90 plus. And also if he is very good, he can also achieve a, you know, like a blastocyst rate more than 60%. So here also embryologist plays a crucial role. So as I mentioned that, you know, there is a major role, you know, to taking care of the, you know, embryo, to taking care of the IVF, to taking care of the culturing of the embryo to the blastocyst, and selection of the sperm, and selection of the embryo, and giving the ambience, you know, like a, you know, uterine ambience, or maybe to mimic the, you know, uterus environment, the embryologist plays a crucial role in the IVF lab. That means he has to maintain the temperature, body temperature like a 37 degrees. He has to maintain the humidity, like a, you know, like a ambient humidity also he has to maintain. He has to maintain the carbon dioxide in an optimal level. You should also maintain the pH of the culture media in an optimal level, 7.2 to 7.4. And you should also maintain the air quality in the laboratory. So these are the, you know, plays a crucial role to achieve a good success rate and also viable pregnancy rate without any abortion, or, you know, to achieve a standard, you know, pregnancy rate. So these details many couple or patient doesn't know. Who does the IVF, who does the ICSI, who does the IMSI procedure, who does the pre-implantation genetic procedure. They think that these all procedure is done by clinician. That is entirely wrong. This procedure will be done by only the qualified and, you know, skilled embryologist. If there is a good embryologist, your success rate will be good. If there is no good embryologist, your IVF success rate is almost zero. So that's what, you know, many people should understand what is the IVF. And you should also basically, you will see the semen sample and tell to the clinician or advise to the clinician saying that the morphology is good, go for an IUI. If the sample is 3 million and above, you will advise, you know, to the, you know, particular clinician, say that go for an IUI. Or if the sample is only, you know, like a very less is there, as I mentioned, occasional sperm, they should go for an ICSI treatment. And if the sample is adequate, woman is young, only, you know, like a tubal factor, he can also advise and do the IVF procedure for the, this particular patient. So these are done by the decision made by the embryologist. You should also know the checking of the semen sample will be done by either andrologist or embryologist. So generally 2000 criteria, what says the normal semen sample? The normal volume has to be 1.5 ml and the concentration has to be 15 million per ml and the total number of sperms will be in the per ejaculate is 39 million per ejaculate and total motility should be more than 40% and the vitality should be more than 58% and the strict morphology criteria, normal morphology has to be 4%. So you should know that. And many people think that, you know, the ICSI is a very simple technique. We can catch any one of the sperm and the IK portion of the egg and then you will get the embryo. So that is entirely wrong. That is just only, you know, the technician will be done like that. But if you are a really qualified embryologist, if you have a very good knowledge on, you know, mammalian biology or maybe in andrology, or, you know, if you know the molecular biology of that, you know, sperm biology, everything, if you know that, you should know how to select the best sperm. Generally, sperm head or contains the nucleus. This nucleus is very important to achieve a viable pregnancy in a routine, you know, IVF or ICSI. So you should know that, you know, the sperm, you know, should be oval shaped, and the length has to be 3 to 5 micrometer, and the width has to be 2 to 3 micrometer, and then the acrosome area, you should clearly see that it has to be 40 to 70% of the acrosome area has to be occupied in the head area without any vacuum. If you know this is the best sperm, you can select this sperm for a microinfection. A single tail about 50 micrometer length has to be there, and then the midpiece region has to cover 7 to 8 micrometers. So this criteria he has to fix in the mind and look for the, you know, like when you do ICSI, then you look for this type of sperm and then select those sperm and go for ICSI treatment. The embryologist can achieve a good fertilization and good embryo quality, viable embryo when you transfer this embryo, and you will achieve a good, you know, success rate. So many people doesn't know this. Just simply, you know, they see the sperm, whichever is going, they quickly, you know, they collect the sperm and push into the egg. They don't know the importance of the nucleus. And you should also, you know, will analyze and tell you which type of injection is giving you good quality oocyte. Because oocyte is looked by only embryologist, not a clinician. The oocyte is looked by only embryologist in the microscope, and you will see the oocyte morphology, like how is the cumulus structure, how is the coronal radiator cells, or how is the egg quality, is it a vacuolated egg, or is it a, you know, like an abnormal oocyte, or extra zona pellucida, or maybe centrally granular pitting oocyte, or maybe, you know, granular cytoplasm, or maybe fragile cytoplasm. All those things can be looked in the microscope, done by only an embryologist. He can say that the egg quality is good or bad. He can also analyze with the injection, like if you give a HMG, what is the quality of egg? If you give a, you know, like a FSH, what is the quality of egg? If you give a recombinant FSH, what is the quality of egg? If you trigger with the HCG, what is your quality of egg? If you trigger with the nuprite, what is the quality of egg? These things can be analyzed by only embryologists. As I mentioned again and again, if there is a good embryologist, you can achieve a very good success rate. And you should also know that, you know, embryo should not expose the egg for a long time, either during the ICSI or during the IVF insemination. You should maintain the temperature, and also you should also know that which is a good quality egg, which is a bad quality oocyte. And you should also evaluate the sperm before IVF, you know, whether the sperm quality is good or bad. You know, sometimes the sperm looks, you know, low magnification, very good. But when you do a higher magnification, like a 400 times, or maybe more than 400 times, we can see the sperm quality will be bad. So those samples, you know, they may not fertilize in IVF. So you should also adequate knowledge on, you know, to look for which is a good sperm, which is a, you know, not very good quality sperm. And you should also know how to prepare the sample, you know, like a PISA sample, like a percutaneous epidermosperm aspiration sample, or microepidermosperm aspiration sample, or maybe testicular tissue. So if you collect the testicular tissue, how to tease the microtubule, from the microtubule how to identify the sperms, and how to collect these sperms and injection for a microinjection. This need a special tools. So that's why most of the time, you know, like a male factor, woman will be very good, wonderful, you know, because her hormones are fine, everything is okay. Only husband doesn't have a sperm. That's why you know, like most of the people, they don't come, you know, get a pregnancy. But this male factor, if you do properly ICSI, or if you do properly, you know, selection of the sperm, the success rate will be very good. And so generally when you are doing the ICSI also, many people, you know, to try to select the sperm in a 200 magnification. But I do maximum, you know, like higher magnification, more than 400 or more than 6,600 times. Maybe you can call it as a, you know, 400 times magnification, or maybe IMSI technique. You can look for the sperm quality, look for the sperm head. Then you should look for the, you know, how the plasma membrane of the, you know, sperm head look like, or maybe any irregular, or maybe the membrane is rough, or maybe inside any vacuole is there, or the vitreous is broken, or mitochondria is not very healthy. These things can be thoroughly checked or examined in the, like 6,600 times or 8,800 times, and then select the best quality sperm and go for ICSI. You always get the best quality embryo. An embryologist also do sometimes, if there is a poor quality sperm, he can also do a, like a pixie ICSI, that means physiological ICSI. We can put a, you know, sperm in the hyaluronan coated dish, and then the sperms will be moving, and whichever is a good quality sperm, those sperms can be selected, and then collected those sperms, and then again introduced to the TED, and then you crush the sperm and introduce it to the egg. It's called the intracytoplasmic sperm injection. So you can select the euploid sperms, and then you can also get the best quality embryo. So when you transfer this type of embryo, the patient can get pregnancy, especially in those cases already, you know, like a repeated abortion due to the male factor. That means DNA, sperm DNA fragmentation is very high, or maybe sperm has a vacuolated egg, or maybe the fragmented, you know, like a DNA fragmented, those sperm and so introduced into the egg, they may give you a good quality embryo, but finally they will not give you the ongoing pregnancy. This also, as I mentioned, this procedure also done by embryologist. So if he has a skilled embryologist, even with this technique, you can achieve a good quality embryo. And again, you know, there are some immotile sperms. Our sperms are not moving. They are very bad quality, you know, sperms. None of them are moving. That normally we call as a, you know, necrosospermia. So these sperms we should know whether they are live or dead. So the embryologist should know that how to perform a HOST technique. That means hypoosmotic swelling test, to identify which one is the viable, which one is the dead sperms. So whichever is taking the water inside and then curling the tail, that's basically it's the live sperms. Whichever is not responding to the hypoosmotic solution, they are dead sperms. We have a couple from Japan, and then they did one or two IVF, and they came to us. And this is a purely embryologist technique. And we just, you know, exposed to this sperm to the HOST test, and then the some of the sperms are curling, some of the sperms are not responding to the treatment. So we did a stimulation, we collect the egg, use the HYS solution for identifying the viable sperm. We took those sperm and injected. Finally, the baby, the mother got the female healthy child. So even with the bad quality sperm also, the embryo is very good, we can achieve a good success rate. Sometimes, you know, we see in the file the fertilization failure, even with the ICSI or IVF. So IVF they've done, fertilization failure. ICSI also done, fertilization failure. So those type of patients, what we can do is actually we'll call it as a modified ICSI. Modified ICSI means generally in the periphery of the oocyte, the mitochondria copies will be more. So you have to go deeper when you are micro-injecting or when you are doing ICSI technique, and how, you know, take the cytoplasm from the periphery and then you inject into the oocyte. So and take a little bit more cytoplasm and inject into the oocyte. This type of oocytes can be fertilized and also achieve a, you know, embryo, and then you can also transfer to the woman. They can also achieve a pregnancy rate. For this also you need a good skilled embryologist to get the even fertilization failure in ICSI cycle. If there is a good, you know, skilled embryologist, you can achieve a good fertilization rate, and then, you know, subsequently you can also get a success rate. Some patients, they don't like to go for a, you know, donor egg program, and because of the, you know, like they are you know, religious, or maybe they are particular, you know, like religious, they don't allow the donor egg program. So those patients, we can also counsel them for called as a cytoplasmic transfer. So cytoplasmic transfer in the sense, we collect only cytoplasm from the donor, and then we can introduce to the aged woman, more than 40 year old, with along with the husband's sperm. You mix with the donor cytoplasm and husband's sperm, and directly you can introduce to the aged woman, like a more than 40 years aged woman, oocyte. You can put them and then mix them, then do intracytoplasmic sperm injection. Even with the aged woman, they can get the good success rate. So that also done by like a embryologist. If he has a skilled embryologist, even 40 plus oocyte, he can achieve a viable pregnancy. And there is another technique is called as the IMSI technique, intracytoplasmic morphologically selected sperm injection. This is mainly done by embryologist, and especially some patient like a male factor, like a DNA fragmentation levels are very high, previously many times abortion due to the sperm morphology or maybe the poor quality of sperms. This patient can be done a special technique called as an IMSI technique. This is a one step advanced in the IMSI technique. We just magnify the sperm more than 6600 times and select those best sperm without any vacuole, and those sperm can be identified and then do intracytoplasmic sperm injection, and then we can achieve a good quality embryo. These embryo when they transfer, we can avoid the like a previously abortion. So you can avoid the IMSI technique using this particular technique, you can avoid the missed abortion. And you should also know what is the extended culture, and you should also know what is the sequential culture. Generally, if there is a good embryologist, good ambient, is maintaining the laboratory perfectly, they can do all the patient like a blastocyst transfer. So in our center, we do for all the patient blastocyst transfer. That means we don't do day 2 transfer, we don't do day 3 transfer. We allow the embryo for up to 5 days. That's more than 100 cells. And then we select the best embryo as a blastocyst and transfer. The success rate also good. We can avoid the ectopic pregnancy, and also we can get the viable pregnancy rate is very high. So you should also know which media to use, how to culture, and then how to get the viable embryo. And the embryo should also know the sound knowledge on assisted hatching. So some of the aged women, more than 40 years and above, they have a difficulty in hatching. Means generally the zona pellucida is more than 15 micrometer has to be there. Less than 15 micrometer has to be there. But some of the patients, they have a more than 50 micrometers. That means very thick zona pellucida. So inside embryo nicely formed, they become a good blastocyst, but they couldn't able to come up from the zona pellucida because of the age factor or maybe thick zona pellucida. So these type of things where we can observe, like a stage 4 endometriosis or maybe severe PCO or more than 40 year old lady. So this type of oocyte you can identify. For them, the treatment is called as a assisted hatching or laser assisted hatching. Nothing, just simply you can expose the embryo in the micromanipulator and then bring the 40x object to with the laser. Then you just fire them. Only the particular area of zona pellucida will be removed. And then we can open the zona pellucida around 15 to 20 micrometers. And then you can allow the embryo for like a hatching. You can do hatched embryo or just hatching embryo can be selected and transferred. Still patient can get a pregnancy. And you should also know, the blastocyst transfer always give you the viable embryo or viable pregnancy. At the same time, it can also reduce the ectopic pregnancy because the size of the blastomere is very big compared to the 2-cell embryo or 4-cell embryo, 8-cell embryo. So when you transfer the blastocyst embryos, the ectopic pregnancy also we can lower down. And embryo selection also crucial role. The embryologist know what is the A grade and B grade and C grade and D grade, and you should know which is the best quality, which is the like a second grade or third grade. So if you know how to select the best quality embryo, the implantation also will be very high. And the embryologist should also know the embryo biopsy technique. Suppose some patients are getting frequently like abortions, or maybe some of the patients repeated embryo transfer, but still the patients are not getting pregnancy, and or they are getting or maybe in like 2 months, 3 months abortion is coming up. So those patients, you should also know what is the embryo biopsy, how to do the biopsy for blastomere, how to do the blast biopsy for, you know, trophoderm cells, how to do the polar body biopsy, and these things you should know. So if you know that, we can remove the few blastomia or, you know, like a trophoderm cells, they can do the tubing, and then they can send for the, you know, like a PGT and PGS, and then we can, they can identify which is a normal embryo, which is abnormal embryo. Those embryos can be transferred. Still patient can get a pregnancy in a previous repeated cycle already failed. With this technique, they can get the viable pregnancy. So these are the, you know, methods, you know, the embryo should know to do the, you know, like a best outcome. And embryo should also know how to load the embryo for embryo transfer, you know, like an air column and media, and then air bubble, and then the media all together. It should be not exceed more than a, you know, 10 to 15 microliters maximum. So we transfer less than 10 microliters. So when you do that, you can avoid the ectopic pregnancy, and also you can increase the take-home baby pregnancy also. And the embryologist also plays a crucial role in freezing technique. You know, like if there is a cancer patients are there, we can freeze the ovarian tissue, we can freeze the eggs, we can freeze the sperms, we can also make an embryo, and we can freeze the embryo, or we can also freeze the, you know, like a blastocyst. So as already mentioned, gamete freezing, there is a big role in embryologist. It should be used to freeze the egg, sperm, embryo, testicular tissue, and ovarian tissue. So these are the main thing, you know, to maintain the lab. And maintain the lab, maintain the, you know, cryopreservation samples, maintain the temperature in the lab, maintain the incubator temperature, maintain the microscope temperature, maintain the carbon dioxide level, maintain the air quality, and maintain the liquid nitrogen levels in the, you know, tanks, and also you also maintain the strict quality control. So you should also check every 3 months once what is the fertilization rate, what is the polyspermic rate, what is the embryo cleavage rate, what is the blastocyst rate, and what is the cryopreservation survival rate. So these are the major role embryologists play. So many people doesn't know who is embryologist, and they don't know what they does. I hope, you know, this the detailed elaboration of technique, many people will know now who is exactly the embryologist. Thank you so much. Thank you. So this type of oocyte you can identify. For them, the treatment is called as a assisted hatching or laser assisted hatching. Nothing, just simply you can expose the embryo in the micromanipulator, and then bring the 48 subject to with the laser. Then you just fire them. Only the particular area gonopilastra will be removed, and then we can open the gonopilastra, open the gonopilastra around 15 to 20 micrometers, and then you can allow the embryo for, you know, like a hatching. You can do hatched embryo or just hatching embryo can be selected and transferred. Still patient can get a pregnancy. And you should also know, you know, the blastocyst transfer always give you the viable, you know, embryo or viable pregnancy. At the same time, it can also reduce the ectopic pregnancy because the size of the blastomere is very big compared to the 2-cell embryo or 4-cell embryo, 8-cell embryo. So when you transfer the blastocyst embryos, the ectopic pregnancy also we can worry about. And embryo selection also crucial role. The embryologist know what is the A grade and B grade and C grade and D grade, and you should know which is the best quality, which is the, you know, like a second grade or third grade. So if you know how to select the best quality embryo, the implantation also will be very high. And the embryologist should also know the embryo biopsy technique. Suppose some patients are getting frequently, you know, like abortions, or maybe some of the patients repeated, you know, embryo transfer, but still the patients are not getting pregnancy, and or they are getting, or maybe in a, like 2 months, 3 months, abortion is coming up. So those patients, you should also know what is the, you know, like embryo biopsy, how to do the biopsy for blastomere, how to do the biopsy for, you know, trophoderm cells, how to do the polar body biopsy, and these things you should know. So if you know that, you can remove the few blastomere or, you know, like a trophoderm cells, they can do the tubing, and then they can send for the, you know, like a PGT and PGS, and then they can identify which is a normal embryo, which is abnormal embryo. Those embryos can be transferred. Still patient can get a pregnancy in a previous repeated cycle already failed. With this technique, they can get the viable pregnancy. So these are the, you know, methods, you know, the embryo should know to do the, you know, like a best outcome. And embryologist will also know how to load the embryo for embryo transfer, you know, like a air column and media and then air bubble and then the media all together. It should be not exceed more than a, you know, 10 to 15 microliters maximum. So we transfer less than 10 microliters. So when you do that, you can avoid the ectopic pregnancy and also you can increase the take-home baby pregnancy also. And the embryologist also plays a crucial role in freezing technique. You know, like if there is a cancer patients are there, we can freeze the ovarian tissue, we can freeze the eggs, we can freeze the sperms, we can also make an embryo and we can freeze the embryo, or we can also freeze the, you know, like a blastocyst. So as already mentioned, gamut freezing, there is a big role in embryologist. It should be used to freeze the egg, sperm, embryo, testicular tissue and ovary tissue. So these are the main thing, you know, we maintain the lab. And maintain the lab, maintain the, you know, cryopreservation samples, maintain the temperature in the lab, maintain the incubator temperature, maintain the microscope temperature, maintain the carbon dioxide level, maintain the air quality, and maintain the liquid nitrogen levels in the, you know, tanks, and also you also maintain the strict quality control. So you should also check every 3 months once what is the fertilization rate, what is the polyspermic rate, what is the embryo cleavage rate, what is the blastocyst rate, and what is the cryopreservation survival rate. So these are the major role embryologists play. So many people doesn't know who is embryologist, and they don't know what they does. I hope, you know, this the detailed elaboration of technique, many people will know now who is exactly the embryologist. Thank you so much. Thank you.